Come on, focus, 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 focus. Hi, guys. So I did not film an intro for this video because it ended up being a continuation of my last video. If you didn't see it, I did a Q&A. I ended up getting a bunch of questions and a ton of them were just like fandom related, but some were personal. So I ended up splitting it into two videos. If you're interested in the personal Q&A, I will link it down below, but that's what that video was. This video is now all just like One Direction, Harry, fandom related questions. But I just wanted to come on here really quick to tell you guys something. This week is very exciting. If you don't know, I mean, if you're watching this video, you probably definitely know. This week is One Direction's 10-year anniversary on Thursday, July 23rd. I can't believe it's already here. Like, it's so weird. I feel like we were talking about this in like January and now it's already July. It's just, time doesn't make sense anymore, but I knew I wanted to film something for the anniversary. I'm like, okay, I'm for sure gonna post a video that day. But then a few days ago, I'm just like, I can do better than that. So I'm actually gonna be posting a video every day this week, a One Direction related video every day. I don't totally know if it's gonna be like Monday through Friday or just the whole week. I have several ideas. I am literally gonna film and edit until my brain and eyeballs fall out this weekend, but I don't care. It's worth it. It's gonna be fun. If you are not a person that is here for my One Direction content, like, I'm sorry. You can just ignore me this week and come back. I promise next week I'm gonna have like moving vlogs and clothing hauls and just all sorts of different things like that. But this week is, this is my week. This is my time to shine. I'm having fun with it. I just know this week is gonna be fun no matter what we actually get from the boys. Like, I know like social media is just gonna be exploding. It's gonna be lots of nostalgia. It's gonna be great. If you are like fully committed and wanna see me in like full clown mode, I highly recommend following me on Twitter. I'm always active on there, but I'm gonna be especially active this week because I just have a feeling it's gonna be crazy. My at is golden_styles. The L is a capital I. Don't ask me why, but yeah, just wanted to tell you guys that. Hope you're along for the ride, but I'll just get into the Q&A now. Okay, I feel like that is a good time to transition over to all of the fandom related questions. For some reason, a lot of people decided to ask me questions that were like my favorites, and like, I'm not good with favorites because I'm indecisive, so I'm probably gonna be giving a lot of like top threes because I just, you can't make me choose, especially when it comes to stuff like Harry. Like, it's just not, it's not happening. What's your favorite Louis solo from 1D? Okay, I love Louis with all of my heart. He was probably always, like, after Harry, he was probably always my second favorite. Like, I love Louis. He's also just, like, so underrated, dude. Like, some certain songs on 1D, like, he wrote a majority of them, which, like, we need to just get that out there. Like, 1D would not be what it was without Louis. But just voice-wise, like, Rock Me, one of my absolute favorite songs. Like, he owned that song. Little Black Dress, owned it. Like, just so many songs like would not have been what they were without him. What first comes to mind though, my favorite solo of his would probably be in Better Than Words, which again, one of my favorites. I just love his solo in that song. Like, that part I'm always just like, like, it's just, it's good. He kills it. So probably Better Than Words, but there's many others that I also love. What is the best and worst Harry hair? Like, why would you ask this question? I hate it here. Okay, so my top three Harry hairs have to be, I mean, Dunkirk is just superior. You might be able to tell I'm a little bit biased to that. I just think that was such like movie star energy, his hair. Like, it was after he like cut it, and it was just like, it was like a reawakening, you know? He was like a butterfly coming out of his chrysalis, is that what it's called? I don't know. I just, Dunkirk was amazing. The suits, I know we're talking about the hair, but it just all together, Dunkirk was amazing. Also, I mean, just like headband era for sure was a time to be alive. I know that's not exactly like hair, but it's a hairstyle, so I'm letting it count. Like, Dreamboat, it just, it did things to me. I gotta love headband. That's gotta be in the top three. And then third, and possibly like this battles daily with Dunkirk in my heart, but like Japan Harry, so underrated. I mean, like, look at this picture. It's just, I just, it blows my mind that the fact that like this man's hair can like look the best it ever has, like the one time in his life when he's just like not getting it styled or putting any effort into it, and it's just like free flowing. It was just long, it was the curls, it was fluffy, it just was, It was beautiful. I love Japan Harry. I wish people talked about it more. But of course I have to give an honorable mention of SNL hair because it wasn't really an era. It was just a single night, but like, it was a night we will never forget. Those, that middle part, those smooth waves, like he just came out and I was like, okay, like it just, it was fantastic. Worst hair. This is where I get slaughtered. So here's the thing. We're not gonna say worst, we're just gonna say personal preference because nobody's gonna agree with me, but by far I think my least favorite era of Harry's hair would have to be Prince hair, but just like a really specific portion of Prince hair when it was in that really awkward length where it like wasn't short and it wasn't long and it was just like right to his chin and it was like super curly. Like, of course, obviously when it grew out a little bit and it was a little like fluffier and more free flowing and then it transitioned into the long, like that was beautiful, chef's kiss, all of that. But like when it was just really short, I just thought it was like, I know everyone was like, he looks like a prince. It was a little poodly. It was a little George Washington-y for my personal taste. You don't have to agree. Like he never looks bad, okay? He never looks bad, but like, moving on. Which one detour was your favorite one, whether you attended or not? Okay, I don't wanna get emotional, but I never actually got to see One Direction in concert. Don't want to talk about it, my biggest regret in life, but if I had to, that's so hard. Like favorite One Direction tour, I mean, like my gut is telling me Where We Are, just because like, again, headband Harry, that was like, Zayn was still there. It's hard, like Otra is incredible, like long hair Harry, fully in motion, like confident, bam, out there. But like, Zayn wasn't there, and I just, if I have to pick like one tour, I gotta pick one that Zayn was there for sure. So I would say Where We Are would have to be my favorite. Like that was just like, they were reaching their peak. Like that whole era was just like, I feel like 1D's kind of like prime, you know? So Where We Are. Top five worst 1D songs. You guys are really trying to get me killed. Okay, I'm just gonna scroll through the albums and just off the top of my head, like say the ones that I typically skip. I know it's not gonna be more than five, so I'm nervous. Okay, Up All Night, Na Na Na, I literally like always skip. I know like a lot of people like that one, but I just can't, man. That song, it's not my favorite. Okay, controversial. Little Things, She Can Go. I'll get out of the shower to skip Little Things. It's just not my cup of tea. Even though I can't go to bed without a cup of tea. I'm sorry, that was gross. But yeah, as I've said, mushy gushy, like, you're so perfect. You're like, I wouldn't change anything about you. Like, I just don't go for those type of songs. So that one I usually skip. Okay, Harry, I'm so sorry. I really am, but Something Great, I pretty much never listen to that song. I don't know, it puts me to sleep. It's just not one of my favorites, so that's a skip. I think it's kind of perfectly enough that there's like one from each album. Okay, again, controversial, Act My Age. It's just not for me. It reminds me of like Peter Pan. I know that's random, but I just think of like the Lost Boys being like da-da-da-da-da, which like, sure, that's fun. And like whenever they performed it on tour and they were all dancing around and stuff, like, yeah, it was like a fun time. But like, I never choose to listen to that song. And if it comes on, I often skip it. I'm sorry. And then the last one on Made in the AM. Okay, this song is like, they sound great in it. It's a like beautiful song. I get why people like it, but I just never, ever, ever listen to it unless I'm just like really depressed or feeling some type of way. I Wanna Write You a Song. I know some people that's like literally one of their favorites, but it's not one of mine. So I'm sorry. I guess, yeah. Na Na Na, Little Things, Something Great, Act My Age, and I Wanna Write You a Song. Not their worst songs, but my least favorites. Okay, what is your favorite suit from HS1? Again, How dare you? There were just so many amazing moments from HS1. Just like all the suits, all the different nights, it was incredible. If I have to pick like a top three, I believe it was London. It was this suit where it was the black with like the silver stripes and it was sparkly. It was beautiful. I love, my thing is like Harry in black and Harry in pink are just like all I need in my life. Those are his two colors where it's like two completely different ends of the spectrum, but both of them just like make me feel some type of way. So I loved that black sparkly suit. I also loved the pink sparkly suit. I wanna say that was like Buenos Aires, might be wrong, but this one, it was so fun. I loved it. He just looked great that night. Also like St. Paul, his sparkly pink ruffled shirt, like that was the best performance of Medicine. Just like everything about that night was iconic from the first tour. Okay, also just like the final show. Like that was a moment, that was a look. It was just, that was the night he performed Kiwi 3 times. I know we're specifically talking about the suit, but the suit is attached to like memories and feelings. So that one was also great. For my show, Houston, he wore like the black shirt, which a lot of people were like, that was his worst outfit on tour. Like, I get where that's coming from, but like, he just looked so classy. It was so simple and he just looked good. His black like collared shirt, and then he was wearing the iconic loved pants, which I love them. They're really cute. But yeah, if I had to pick a top three, I'll just put the pictures down here because I already forgot what I said, but that would be my top three. What One Direction song would you want Harry to cover on tour? I will say like Harry, obviously he loves What Makes You Beautiful. Like he's just been performing that for since he's been going solo. And especially lately, I feel like he's more into it than ever. And I feel like it's for sure gonna be on the set list for the next tour. But like What Makes You Beautiful is obviously like iconic. It was the first big single and everything. But like I can do without it, you know. I think his version of it is honestly like better than the original. Like it's great, he has a great time, he dances, all of that. But like I loved when he did Stockholm Syndrome on the last tour. That is like one of my favorites. I have so many favorites, like I don't know, but I love Stockholm Syndrome. But my like what first came to mind when he like I read that was Long Way Down. That is like I think one of their most underrated songs ever, and I'm going to say it right now, I think Long Way Down is like the best Harry's voice sounds on One Direction's entire discography. You know what I'm trying to say. I just think his song, his voice on Made in the AM is just like, oh, it was like when he reached his top, like it was just so like deep and raw and like emotional. And that song especially, like, oh, it hurts. It hurts every time I listen to it. Anyways, it's one of my absolute favorites, probably like top five, maybe. I would love to hear him sing Long Way Down on tour. I don't think anyone else will agree with me, but that's my choice. Okay, so I think I'm gonna stop there. I think I kind of hit all the main questions I saw. If you guys want me to do another one of these in the future, you can totally leave questions in the comments down below or tweet them to me or send me a DM on Instagram, whatever. I don't care. I'll just save them and do them in a future video. So yeah, this video might have been 3 hours long. I apologize if so, but thank you guys for sending in your questions. Hope you found this interesting. Hope you don't hate me now. But yeah, lots of fun, exciting stuff coming up. Moving out soon, One Direction 10 year anniversary, all the things. I'm excited for it. I will be back with another video very soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.